Hi guys, Tony D'Angelo here. Welcome to my house. Today we're going to try something just a little bit different. A subscriber had visited my webpage and noticed that I had been to Cuba on occasion. And he asked if I knew how to make a mojito. And strangely enough, I do. When I first arrived at Hemingway Marina, I walked up to the bartender who became a good friend of mine, Miguel. And I said, Miguel, give me whatever the traditional drink is here, because you know I didn't want to just order a beer. And he ran in the back and he started mixing this up. And he told me that this was Ernest Hemingway's favorite drink, that he used to sit in this very bar and drink it. If you look on the internet now, you're going to see a lot of really complicated ingredients to make a mojito. The reality is, those ingredients just weren't readily available in Havana, especially back in Hemingway's day. So this is how Miguel at Hemingway Marina showed me how to make an authentic mojito. Take a look at our ingredients here. We have about 10 ounces of hot water, 3 tablespoons of sugar, 1.5 to 2 ounces of white rum, and a lemon, or a lime. Funny, down there they call this a lemon. I don't know. And some fresh mint. First thing we're going to do is take our sugar, add it to our hot water, and dissolve it. Stir it up until it's all nicely dissolved. Doesn't take very long at all to do that. You'll know because the water will be very clear. Take your time with this and make sure you get it all dissolved. Alright, and we're going to take that and put it in our refrigerator and let it cool off. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is take our mint. You don't need much, that's more than enough. And we're going to remove it from our stem. Like that. We've already rinsed this. Put it in our bowl and do what they call muddling it, basically mashing it up. And you'll know you're getting this great because the smell starts to release. You don't want to grind it up or anything, you just want to crush it so that it starts to release the flavors. Okay, we're going to take about a quarter of this lime, just a wedge of it. Okay, put the rest aside. Now we're going to take about half of these mint leaves, put them in the bottom of our glass. We're going to squeeze our lime in there. And then leave the rest of it. And we're going to take our 2 ounces of rum, add it right there. Now, we have to wait until our sugar mixture cooled down. So we'll get back to you in a bit. It doesn't hurt if you take your spoon and mix this up and release some more of that mint too. Now when we're doing that, I want to talk to you about the fresh mint. You're going to say, where'd you get the fresh mint? Well, a friend of mine up in Ohio shipped me down a $3 mint plant from the Home Depot. And boys, if you can't grow anything, you can grow a mint plant. I'll show you a picture of when I got the plant and what it looks like now. And it's been growing for about a year. I think it's almost a weed, but it's great stuff to have on hand. You can use it for all kinds of things. Okay, I'm back now. The water has cooled down, so we're going to take a handful of ice. And our sugar water. We're going to add our sugar water in there. That like that. Give it a stir. And add our ice. Now a lot of times what you can do is you can make up a big pitcher of the sugar water the night before if you're going to have a little party. It's always easier to stir the drink before you put the ice in. And there you go, a genuine Hemingway Marina mojito courtesy of Miguel. Salud. All right guys, I thank you for watching. I really appreciate the subscribers and the comments. God bless, and remember, Even tough guys can cook.